sometimes on free markets or new, you find these small units that are made to amplify a signal from a cell phone or another source. And often they consist of a quite good amplifier. That's here, for instance. This is a stereo amplifier with two small chips. In fact, it's a good amplifier, no problem at all. And you can use it as a quasi hi-fi amplifier. For hobby use, of course, anyway. The speakers in these boxes are often also good. This is a speaker from the 1980s or 1990s with a good magnetic extra magnet in it. So the bass response is good, etc. And you can use them as a monitor for audio in your hobby shack. This circuit is how you can do that. There is a wall transformer, and that wall transformer is connected here. And of course, be sure that the positive and the negative are properly connected to this unit. This was from a flea market, and I used an old wall transformer, and I had to reverse the positive and the negative to make it function. Anyway, these wall transformers always have hum at their output, so you need, for a serious application, a series regulator. There are videos on YouTube, and I will give the link. Here we see these two boxes that I've showed. This one with the amplifier inside, and that one without an amplifier. And to make it useful as an audio monitor, it's always important that such a quite fragile amplifier must not be connected, shortcutted at its output with a loudspeaker box. And that's the reason why I use here a resistor, 3 ohms, 5 watt. And here also the left channel, and this is the right channel, by the way. And two resistors to prevent that you blow up in a certain way your audio amplifier. And you can see here, for instance, that the amplifiers are not cooled, etc., etc. They say it's a 3 watt amplifier or 5 watt, but anyway, a useful thing is a protective resistor. And then here you can use a hi-fi box for one channel, left channel, and also a hi-fi box for the right channel. And of course, such an amplifier must be free of hum, of course. And you can switch off both speakers that belong to that unit. So I switch off this speaker here with the help of this switch. And also here inside, I'm going to make a switch that I can switch this speaker off and then make a connection to a real hi-fi box. Of course, the amplifier has to have some properties to be used as a quasi hi-fi amplifier, but anyway. And here is the cell phone or another audio source. Sometimes it's necessary to give the signal out of the cell phone to the amplifier via a non-polar capacitor and a resistor. That could be a different earth potential, but when the cell phone is used as a separate unit, that will be no problem. So you can use a cable, a simple cable that can be plugged in here directly. And I mean here directly, without a separating protective input capacitor. Anyway, the whole circuit again. I have to pan over somewhat. In fact, it's all very simple. And well, that was all.